Hello everyone, my name is Pooja Kadam and I am working as Assistant Professor under Civil Engineering Department of Vidyavardhini College of Engineering, Vasai under Mumbai University. Today I will be presenting before you a small topic, that is Introduction to Water Quality under Environmental Engineering. Now, since we all know air, water and food are very essential for human existence. If any of these components are polluted, they can create problems. For example, if the air is polluted, it can pose respiratory problems for human health. Similarly, if water and food are polluted, it can cause damage to the health of individuals. Now, there goes a proverb which says, "Many lived without love, but none without water." So today's presentation is related to general objectives of environmental engineering and a small topic on quality of water. Once you have completed with this presentation, please complete the LBD activities which are present in the form of quizzes. Now, what are the objectives of environmental engineering? First, to supply water which is safe in quality and adequate in quantity to the population. Next, to collect, treat and dispose the wastewater generated in the community. Next, to put in place the methods for pollution prevention in industries and to treat and dispose of the industrial waste. Next, to control air pollution from indoor work environment as well as from the industries. Then, to collect, transport and safely dispose of the municipal and hazardous waste. Thus, environmental engineering branch is not just limited to a single component. It is related to water, wastewater, industrial waste, different types of pollution, as well as the hazardous and municipal solid waste. Now, take a moment and think and write about this reflection spot question. The question is, why do you think environmental engineering is a branch of civil engineering? Once you are done with writing the answer to it, continue with the video. Now, before continuing with the video, according to me, why I feel that environmental engineering is a branch of civil engineering is because environmental engineering involves wastewater management, air pollution control, recycling, waste recycling, industrial hygiene, environmental sustainability, public health, and environmental engineering law. It also includes studies on the environmental impact of proposed construction projects. As a responsibility of civil engineer, it is our work to make this world a beautiful place to live in. And for this, the knowledge of environmental engineering plays an important role. Now let's continue with the further topic. Water quality. Now we all know that civilization emerged on the banks of the river. Initially, much more importance was given to sufficient quantity of water, that is, adequate supply of water to the people, rather than its quality. Later, when there were epidemics and spread of diseases, people realized the importance of quality of drinking water. So initially, in the historic times, water was stored in copper vessels, since copper dissolves in water and it has bactericidal effect, that is, it helps in killing the bacteria, especially the disease-causing bacteria which are present in the water. Now, what are the different attributes or say characteristics of drinking water? First is aesthetic. Drinking water should be free from color, taste, odor and should be pleasing. Next, safety. That is, it should be free from bacteria, especially the disease-causing bacteria which are called the pathogenic bacteria. Lastly, it should be free from chemicals. Toxic chemicals which are imparted into the water naturally as well as anthropogenic, that is imparted due to the man-made activities. Thank you for watching this video.